Hello, in this video we will solve this problem. Find IR of T. IR is the current flowing through this resistance. And there is a switch here, it closes at T equal to 0. And we have one more resistor here and 12 millihenry inductance and 2 picofarad capacitance. Okay, so as usual, step 1. For t less than 0, t less than 0, the switch is opened, it is not closed. So our circuit will be, this is 4 volt and 2k, and we have capacitance and resistance here. So this is 12 milli and 2k, this is 30k and 2 pico, and our IR, this is our IR, and current flowing through this is IL and this is VC. Okay, this is t less than 0, only thing is switch is open. So this is our circuit. For t greater than 0, so then this switch is closed. So since this switch is closed, this 4 volt battery and 2k ohm resistor, this part of the circuit is separated from this. How? Because all the currents flow through this one, none of the current flows through this part of the circuit. So we can easily separate 4 volt and 2k from the rest of the circuit. Okay, so we can write like this. And this is a short, 4 volt and 2k short. Now here you have, you can write like this, this is 12 milli and 30k, current flowing through this is IL, this is IR, and capacitor you have here and 2 pico with this, with VC voltage. Okay, this is t greater than 0. So this, all the current from the 4 volt battery will flow through like this only. Okay, so here the current and voltage are due to the initial condition of the inductor and capacitor. Okay, for the, from that you will have the current and voltage here. Okay, step 1, we will start with step 1. That is step 1. So step 1, we have to first find whether, identify whether it is parallel or series RLC. You can see here, when this part is removed, then inductance is in parallel with resistance and in parallel with the capacitance. All the three are in parallel. So it is a parallel RLC. And we have to find alpha. So alpha is 1 by 2 RC. So if you substitute and calculate, you will get 8.33 into 10 power 6 per second. Okay, and omega naught, if you calculate, it is 1 by root LC. That is nothing but if you substitute and calculate, it is 6.45 into 10 power 6. Okay, so if you compare alpha and omega naught, alpha is greater than omega naught. So if it is greater than omega naught, the response is overdamped response. Overdamped response. Response what you get is overdamped response. Okay, so overdamped response, then you have to calculate S1 and S2. So S1 is minus alpha plus under the square root alpha square minus omega naught square, and S2 is minus alpha minus under the square root alpha square minus omega naught square. Here you will get, if you substitute again alpha and omega naught, you will get value minus 3.063 into 10 power 6, okay, per second. And this will be, my S2 will be minus 13.6 into 10 power 6 per second. Okay, so these are the S1 and S2 value we will get. So that is about the step 1. Now we will see the step 2. Step 2. So in this we will find all the initial values, initial condition of the capacitance and inductance. So first one is IL of 0 minus we have to find. So circuit is here. This is IL of 0 minus. So what happens here at t equal to 0 minus, the inductance act like a short and capacitor act like an open circuit. So this circuit essentially becomes a 4 volt battery with two resistance, 2k and 30k. So we have to calculate current passing through this inductor, that is it act like a short circuit. So it is simply using KVL you can calculate, it is 4 volt divided by 32 kilo ohm. So, and also you can see the IL now, IL of 0 minus is equal to IR of 0 minus, because at t equal to 0 minus capacitor will act like a open circuit. So IL current will be equal to IR current. So I have to write that one, that is IR of 0 minus, and that is equal to total voltage and total resistance. So if you divide, you get 125 microampere will get. Okay, that is about the IL naught. Now VC of 0 minus we have to calculate, that is the open circuit voltage. At t equal to 0 minus, this capacitor act like a open circuit, so I have to find voltage across this inductor. Anyhow, it is act like a short, so it is simply the voltage, using voltage divider we have to find what is the voltage across this 30 k ohm resistance. Okay, so that is, if you substitute 4 volt into 30 k divided by total resistance 32 k, so you will get 3.75 volt. So from this we can write IL of 0 plus is nothing but IL of 0 minus, that is 125 microampere, and VC of 0 plus is equal to VC of 0 minus equal to 3.75, because inductor resists abrupt change in current, capacitor resists abrupt change in the voltage. So these two we can write easily. Now what you have to calculate is the IR plus. So IR plus you cannot calculate simply using IR of 0 minus, because it's a resistance, here current can change instantaneously. So what is IR of 0 plus now? So IR of 0 plus, let us see that for circuit. At t equal to 0, this part of the circuit is not there. At t equal to 0 plus, this part of circuit is not there. This act like a current source and this act like a voltage source. So now what we want? We want to find the current flowing through this 30 k ohm resistor. Why this current due to this, or current is flowing through this 30 kilo ohm resistance due to the voltage across, or voltage source across this resistance? Because capacitor act like a voltage source at t equal to 0 plus. So you want to calculate the current flowing through this resistance, simply you divide what is the voltage across resistance, that is nothing but VC of 0 plus. VC of 0 plus we have calculated 3.75, divide by this 30 k ohm resistor. So that will give the current flowing through this resistor. Okay, so now IR of 0 plus is simply VC, because a capacitor is connected across that resistor. So VC of 0 plus divided by resistance. Resistance is 30 k. Since capacitor voltage cannot change instantaneously, this voltage is fixed across the resistor at t equal to 0 plus. Okay, so that voltage, if you substitute and calculate, 3.75 divided by 30 k, if you do, that is nothing but 125 microampere is the current. Okay, so these are all the initial values. IR 0 plus we need, we calculated, and we need IL of 0 plus and VC of 0 plus to calculate two constants. Okay, so now step 3. So step 3 is the response you have to write. So IRT is the response we need. So that is nothing but it is overdamped response. So it is e power s1t plus a2 e power s2t. In that, IR of 0 already we know, that is 125 microampere. So substitute t equal to 0. So if you substitute t equal to 0 in the above equation, this will become a1 plus a2. So we have one equation relating a1, a2. But we need one more equation. So how to get that one? See, this IR of 0 plus, we found using what? Using the VC of 0 plus. From that condition we found. Now we have to find one more constant. Sorry, we need one more equation to calculate the two constants a1 and a2. So how to get that another equation? The best idea is you know the VC of t. VC of t is what? VC of t is voltage across the resistance, that is 30k into IR of t. IR of t. Now one more equation we can get simply by differentiating dVc by dt divided by dt and evaluate at t equal to 0. Evaluate at t equal to 0, then you will get one more equation. And this dVc by dt at t equal to 0 can be equated to IC of 0 plus divided by C. Like we similar procedure we have done for other problem also. First you find one equation you get using VC condition, another equation you get using IC condition. IC condition can be obtained from the IL condition. Okay, so this will be 30k and d by dt of IRT. IRT we know now, it is a1 e power s1t plus a2 e power s2t. Okay, so and if you differentiate and evaluate at t equal to 0, 0 plus or 0, so this will be 30k a1 s1 plus a2 s2. We know s1 and s2. So you substitute, and this left hand side I can write, this is nothing but IC of 0 plus divided by C, that is equal to dVc by dt at t equal to 0 plus. So this, if you substitute and write that 30k and a1 value you have to calculate, and s1 value we already know that it is 3.063 10 power 6 and again minus a2 into 13.6 into 10 power 6 a2 is written already. So this equation, now what we need is IC of 0 plus. We need now IC of 0 plus. So better we write the circuit at t equal to 0 plus. What is the equivalent circuit? That is here I no need to consider this part, and this circuit I have to draw. This one IL is flowing like this, IR is flowing downward, IC also we will take according to passive sign convention, we will take this direction. So totally it is, if we draw that circuit here, the inductor, resistance and capacitor. So current flowing through this is IC, current flowing through this is IR, and current flowing through this is IL. So we are calculating at 0 plus, so I will write at 0 plus. So at 0 plus, here, so if you write that, what is that IC of 0 plus? IC of 0 plus is equal to IL of 0 plus minus IR of 0 plus. Both we know, IL of 0 plus and IR of 0 plus, both we know, we have calculated that. See, IL of 0 plus is 120, IR of 0 also 125 microampere. So we will just substitute that 125 micro minus 125 micro, that is nothing but 0. So if you substitute this IC plus equal to 0 in this equation, that is this one, if you substitute, so what you will get? You will get
माइनस 3.063 इंटू 10^6 ए वन माइनस 13.6 इंटू 10^6 ए टू इक्वल टू जीरो. यू हैव टू इक्वेशन, वन इज दिस वन, अनदर वन इज वी हैव हियर, दैट इज ए वन प्लस ए टू इज 125 माइक्रो एम्पियर. सो इफ यू यूज दोज टू इक्वेशन एंड कैलकुलेट, यू विल गेट एक्सप्रेशन फॉर, सो यू विल गेट टू कॉन्स्टेंट. ए वन इज 161.3 माइक्रो एम्पियर यू विल गेट, यू वेरीफाई दिस. एंड ए टू इज माइनस 36.34 माइक्रो एम्पियर यू विल गेट. ओके, सो देन IR of t, सो वी विल गेट वेन t इज लेस देन जीरो, सो दैट टाइम वी हैव कैलकुलेटेड इट इज 125 माइक्रो एम्पियर. And for t greater than 0, using this equation we have to find, that is a1 161.3 microampere into micro into e power s1t, that is minus 3.063 into 10^6. Next one minus a2, that is 36.34. micro e power minus 13.6 into 10^6. Okay, this is for t greater than 0. That is the solution.